actually got to break things down and work on the little things, and we've worked really hard these past 3 weeks to prepare for today.
This is kind of a rematch of last year, just different seed numbers. Talk about the matchup with Fairmont State and the opportunity to compete against the top seed.
It's exciting for us. It's definitely something big. It's always a fun time competing against Fairmont, so we're excited.
All conference honors came out yesterday. Obviously, first team all conference for you. Talk about what that award means, not only for you, but for your entire team.
Well, we got five, the whole team, so that was exciting. It means a lot. It really shows the hard work that we've all put in. It's exciting to get recognized for it.
For both teams, you know, Frostburg moving forward tomorrow, and whoever does move forward tomorrow out of this meet, you know, they've got 2 days back-to-back, and, you know, it's a lot of endurance, and plus they have event finals in the morning, so you know, it takes a lot out of you, so it's like they can't overlook it, you know, and hold back, but yet on the other hand, they've got to conserve as much as they can.
We got a chance to catch up with a member of Fairmont State as well. Let's hear what Katie Cole had to say about action this afternoon.
It's a great opportunity to be able to host. It's our home gym, so we have that advantage. We've practiced here all year, and I'm really excited to host and have that advantage.
Last year you were knocked off at Frostburg in this tournament, very close meet. Talk about the chance to win the regular season, host it again this year.
It's a comeback this year. We have a lot of fight in us, and we really want this win. We worked all year for this moment. So we want to show what we can do.
Postseason awards came out yesterday. You were the player of the year in the MEC. Talk about that honor and what it means to you and your team.
It's a great honor. I couldn't do it without my team, my coaches, and the other teams in the MEC. There's a lot of competition out there for that spot. So it's a huge honor to be able to say I'm the athlete of the year.
Moments away here from Fairmont State and West Liberty in the 1-4 matchup. Should be a great one as well. Had great action, and the winner of this one meets Frostburg State tomorrow afternoon at 3 p.m. We'll step aside. When we come back, we'll get ready for action here on MEC TV.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
I'm Keith Powell, and I'm in love with helping you get your next car, truck, or SUV. I love saying yes to $2 down. I love saying yes to $200 monthly payments. I love saying yes to up to $2,000 more for your trade. And I love saying yes to your approved with my Keith Says Yes credit approval process. All of this plus a lifetime warranty only at Yes Chevrolet in Hurricane.
Legacy began in 1973, That was the year NCAA Division II was born. And since the very first day, our division has shaped generations of student athletes with a true sense of academics, athletics, and community. That is five decades of graduations, championships, teamwork, and personal development. 50 years of shaping student athletes into world-class leaders. NCAA Division II. Our division, our legacy.
Welcome back here as we join public address as Mountain East Conference awards are being given out for both teams.
From Fairmont State, Isaiah McCord-Carney.
Regular season trophy for Fairmont State as they get to enjoy after coming up just a bit short last year. They find themselves back on top again. Of course, you as well as anybody knows this is a proud program and it's something they take a lot of pride in.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think that sometimes when you do miss out, you know, that one year, that it really fuels the fire that much more and really makes you focus and you know, really gives you that drive to move forward.
You can tell they've enjoyed every single minute of it, and they are ready for more here this evening.
Absolutely.
Of course, we always get a chance to look back and see when both of these teams had previously met, and that was back on February 25th, and Fairmont State getting a pretty convincing win, 262-251.
But that's been a while. And
it's been a lot of time since then.
A lot of things can change, and hopefully we see both teams score higher today, you know, since it is later. Both teams are looking at each other and they're running over to congratulate each other. This is what you love to see, the camaraderie among the teams and the interaction.
But don't be fooled, they're here for business and they can definitely flip the switch when they need to.
Absolutely, absolutely. It's those 2 hours on the mat that is down to business, and when it's over, then most of the time they leave it behind them as well.
We are getting set to go here as we'll kick off with the Hilltoppers shortly. As they'll send out for their Acro Heat as we get ready. And as always, which we expect here as we kick things off in this event, well,
yes, we're really excited. The compulsory event is the first event coming up, and they're going to be doing the same exact skills, identical skills, and they're going to start off with Acro. And we're going to move forward to pyramid and to toss and then to tumbling.
Here come the Hilltoppers. Kayla Gandy, number 0. Abby Horvick, number 3. Another Abby, Abby Swinderman, number 30. And Peyton Fry, number 55. Across the other side, Jillian Hartz, Avery Ray, Katie Imborski, Abby Goodland, and Macy Whipke all part there for the Hilltoppers as well as they head off the mat here.
Yes, they had a really strong beginning, a good start out from the gate, and they should be happy with that performance going through. They may have a little issue in squaring up again on the cradle. And again, you know, we're not the officials. We're just giving it from our point of view, what we see.
Right.
But all the start values begin with a 10. So everything's starting from 10 points, and the deduction will be made from that. And at the end of this event, we will see those totals.
We will see Fairmont State stepping up here shortly. Of course, as we said, the first time they got together, it was a handedly easy win, you could say, at that point in time for Fairmont State. But when we get to this point in time, both teams have changed a lot, as we said. It's not going to be as easy as they think being here at home in front of their home crowd in a 1-4.
And you know, Colin, they always say that hindsight's 20/20, but I really don't think any win's an easy win anymore.
It's like the Fighting Falcons are pretty close to being ready to step out there. Down the list looks like it's going to read as follows. Two of Fairmont State, Chloe Smith, Reagan Mollahan, and Martin. Riley Knotts in that first group for Fairmont State. The second group will follow. We'll catch up with them a little bit later once they make their way out there. Rather interesting here, perhaps maybe taking a bit longer than usual, could you say, over here on this judging side?
Yeah, it's it's a long night for the officials as well. You know, they're in their second meet now, so they're probably just one double checking, making sure they're being accurate and not making any errors.
Yeah, but as close as it was the first time around, all the way up until the end, these are points that definitely matter.
Yes. Not only does every point count, every tenth and hundredth of a point counts as well.
It's that part I like to refer to as calculator math, where you really have to sit down and punch all of those numbers in, because it's really tough sometimes to get all of those zeros and dots and whatnot in the right places, all in the right line.
That's exactly right. I think we're getting ready.
Second group there, Riley Vinson, Olivia Daniels, Cassidy Price, Alexa Wilson, and Elizabeth Maurer as the Fairmont State Fighting Falcons off the mat.
Yes, they had a good performance as well. They may have had a little dip in the cradle. Again, we'll see what the officials say on that call. But overall, a good showing.
West Liberty coming up again here very shortly. Move into the Pyramid Heat now.
The Pyramid Heat, they will have multiple athletes that are out on the mat as compared to the Acro Heat. And you will see there will be two structures that are set, and they will look at the synchronization in addition to the strength of the mid and the base as well.
Next, we have the compulsory Pyramid Heat. First up, the compulsory Pyramid Heat will be West Liberty.
And here are the Hilltoppers. Spot really much of anything there, wouldn't you say?
Both structures look very solid. The tops really had great synchronization on the dismount. As a matter of fact, the tops actually even look alike. Sometimes
tough to tell them apart. Yeah,
sometimes you'll see one structure is a little taller than another because maybe the mid's a little taller or the top's a little taller. And you know, of course, you're not penalized for that, but you want everything to look as much as they can as possibly identical to each other. Good showing.
We'll see the answer coming here from Fairmont State as we continue to move right along in event number one. Toss heat coming up following the conclusion of this. It's interesting, both of these two programs having a bit of parallel, if you will. West Liberty at one point, hosts of the national championship meet, and of course, hosts of the national championship meet coming here in a couple of weeks over on the opposite side.
Yes, that's so exciting. I mean, it's not too often you see the same conference, and not us, but the Mountain East Conference that will be hosting nationals two consecutive years, and we're really excited to bring it to our state.
Next,
here comes Fairmont State. Good catch towards the bottom there on both sides.
Yes, that was another good performance. They executed the both structures very well. Good synchronization from the head turn to the extension of the legs. You can hear someone counting, and again, they're doing that to make sure the synchronization is on point.
It's funny, I was just about to ask you that. I was going to say maybe explain that a bit for some people who might not know what that purpose is and what that does.
Yes, it helps the athletes to really stay synced. And not that even if you don't have two structures, you may only have one structure, but still for that athlete to know when they need to extend their legs, when they need to pop, when they need to catch the cradle. But again, it helps them to stay focused as well.
Coming up here shortly, the toss heat now for the Hilltoppers. And here they come.
Our third heat, the compulsory heat, is the toss. First up, the compulsory toss will be West Liberty.
Yeah.
bit to keep their energy up here as they continue a solid beginning to this meet on their side. Do the Hilltoppers.
Yes, you'll see this part pick up a little faster whenever we have our tosses because it's such a fast event going through. And then the tumbling takes just a little bit longer, a few more skills that are involved. Again, each one of these events in compulsory, these heats in compulsory, are focusing on a 10-point start value.
We'll flip sides here and get ready for Fairmont State coming. Moving right along, here they come. To beat there, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, very, very nice, nicely done. They had really good height, and of course, height is something that officials look for in addition to the technique. When we look at the technique, we're looking at when you lift, when you tuck, when you open, when you kick out of the skill, and your cradle, and seeing if you do have a high catch on the cradle.
Getting ready to close out event number one now. It's the tumbling heat coming up. The members of the Hilltoppers, you can see them getting ready there.
And we see some of the athletes from Fairmont State coming out and readjusting the mats. They're just pushing together a little bit. They notice that they've already gone through one meet, and with the second meet, sometimes they have a tendency to split apart a little bit, and when they're out on the mat, they can feel that. So they're just fixing it before.
Rather take care of it now.
Yes, before West Liberty takes the mat.
Pretty solid effort there, wouldn't you say?
They did. They did. Their layouts, they really did stick those landings on their layouts. A few little steps I saw earlier in the standing tucks or toe touch tucks. One thing that I know the officials look for, legs together, landing with your legs and feet together, and legs together in your back handsprings as well.
And overall, it's a pretty solid opening for the Hilltoppers here, the four seed.
Most definitely is, yes.
We'll close out event number one shortly here with the Fairmont State edition.
Colin, I see another pair of sunglasses over here that you might like to have.
I don't know if those are my style, per se. Don't know if I can wear anything checkered like that. Don't think I can pull it off. Worth a try, but...
Try it.
Lots of fun going on over here on this left side as we wait for Fairmont State to close things out. Looks like they're actually going to get themselves involved here.
Oh, yes, these crowd pleasers, or we call them the wedding songs. Gets everybody moving.
It's funny, I see some people behind us sitting in this crowd here, like you said, getting involved here themselves.
Oh, they definitely are.
Here comes Fairmont State.
Ready. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
would be surprised if we see a large gap in scoring here, as it seems to be very close after this event comes to a close here.
Yeah, I agree. I concur. I think that we can see strengths and weaknesses on both teams when they're executing their skills going through. Now the secret is, do the officials see those as well?
That's a good point, in fact. We'll see what they come up with here after we come back with this break. Fairmont State and West Liberty right here on MEC TV.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
I'm Keith Powell, and I'm in love with helping you get your next car, truck, or SUV. I love saying yes to only $2 down. I love saying yes to $200 monthly payments. I love saying yes to up to $2,000 more for your trade. And I love saying yes to your approved with my Keith Says Yes credit approval process. All of this plus a lifetime warranty only at Yes Ford in Huntington.
Awesome.
Welcome back here, folks, as we get ready for the scores from event number one. Should have them momentarily, then we'll move into event two, the acro portion, as we get ready for that. And while we wait for these scores, why don't we just preview a bit of what the acro event is here in event two.
Yes, as we start the acro, now we're going to see individual pieces come together with different start values.
Anticipated here, 38-36-60 the lead for the Fighting Falcons.
That's a pretty close score. That's less than a point and a half. So now as we start the next part, we're going to see the different start values, and we'll see the strengths of each group as they take the mat for their execution of their skills.
Here are the Hilltoppers. Correct me if I'm wrong here, but maybe perhaps on that initial dismount, something didn't quite necessarily look 100%, if you will, but other than that, it seemed to be a pretty solid addition again.
Yeah, it did. They had a good performance. I think that the officials take into account, with dismounts, like the height that you make and the leg position, body position. They also, the bases, they look at their strength that they have. Are they supporting, are they strong, without shaking. I think it's something
right.
else that we see that sometimes we don't think about. And of course, are there any steps taken by the bases? And I did not see any taken, did you?
Looks like we actually have the scores here in the meantime. We'll take a look at those and we can maybe break it down a little bit more across the board here. Anything really standing out to you that you see at this point in time?
Well, I think that we did see with the acro and the tumbling that they really were neck and neck, very, very close scores. I'm sorry, not tumbling. Acro and Pyramid. They were very, very close. Toss, we saw it start to spread apart just a little bit. You know, I think that we did see good height on Fairmont State. That may have been what they saw in that piece. And, you know, with the tumbling, they're looking at technique, and they always are very hard in tumbling. So I'm sure they're picking up little pieces across the board.
Here come the Fighting Falcons now as they kick off their portion of event two. You can see the excitement on their faces there after that, as they're very excited with the way that that came out. I'd have to agree.
Absolutely. And when you look at all these athletes, you know, they're so strong, and you know, that doesn't come easy. They spend hours and hours in the weight room. They develop that strength, and they're in strength and conditioning programs just like every other sport that we
That's
see
right.
on every college campus.
We'll see West Liberty stepping up here for their sixth element coming up. Winner of this one meets Frostburg State for the tournament championship tomorrow at 3 p.m. right back here once again.
And that'll be a great meet.
Here come the Hilltoppers again. A bit of trouble with a landing over on the right side at the beginning there, but other than that, the Hilltoppers continue to look to string their momentum along.
Yes, they had a very good performance, and not only do they have to execute all of their skills, but they have to do them together. You know, synchronization is the piece that goes into this heat, this sixth element. So they did have a start value of a 9.8. We see Fairmont coming out. They have a 10.8 start value, so something to keep in mind when we see those final scores coming.
We'll see Fairmont State stepping up shortly for their version of the sixth element, and on into the seventh as we continue to move right along here in meet number two this evening. This is Fairmont State looking to defend their regular season and look to stay undefeated within conference meets here after a clean sweep. Here they are again.
Thank you.
Another addition in the books there from the Fighting Falcons. Anything standing out to you in particular?
A very, very good synchronization between the two. They, again, had a start value of a 10.0. One thing that I think is unique, that we do see them do a front tuck off of the opening part of that heat, and I think that that's interesting and fun to see because it's something a little different. You know, sometimes we see a repetition of a lot of, you know, skills from one team to the next, but that's something I see this, I haven't seen too often in too many teams this season.
Leading on the Hilltoppers here, 4 of 7 element as they'll close out their portion of event 2. Can see a little bit disappointed in themselves after that. It might have been a bit of miscommunication perhaps there trying to get things started at the beginning of that.
And I think sometimes that you see that they may hit a skill over and over and over again, and it's that one time something was off, and to me that's what I felt. I felt like the top was just, they weren't expecting that to happen. And it's very unfortunate.
All could come down to maybe just hand placement not being in the right spot, anything like that, really, if you can think about it.
Timing, it's so many factors that go into play.
First real major slip that we've seen on either side so far to this point in time as we wait for Fairmont State to close out event number 2.
Yes. Colin, as we sit here today, it's nice to look around the gym and see how the Mountain East Conference has really done a very, very nice job, very classy, and the banners and all the signage that is up.
Very aware of their branding, and they do a great job of promoting it for, realistically, every single championship.
Yes, they do. Very nice.
Here's Fairmont State. Like to watch the concentration on the faces up top, and you could see that from a mile away.
Oh yes, you can. And it's one thing you must notice, that like each balanced position has to be held a minimum of 3 seconds, and of course they only have 45 seconds to do it, so they've got to be on point when they do that, especially within this last one. They had quite a few balanced positions that they had to hold.
We'll step aside here. We'll have scores for event 2 as we get ready to start event number 3 here on MEC TV.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division 2, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
What's possible when you have the freedom to explore things that inspire you? To be a part of a community that supports and challenges you? Where can you go to find the space and time to reach your goals? Who can you become when you're able to make connections in a place where you belong? Find out what's possible at Frostburg State University.
Welcome back here, folks, as we wait for the scores from event number two, and then we'll move into the pyramid event. Why don't we do a quick breakdown of the pyramid event as we wait for these scores?
As we go forward with our pyramid, we will see three heats, and the second heat being synchronized pyramid. With pyramid, you'll see more athletes out on the floor with each one. And again, we'll see a few different pyramids as well. So it looks like within the pyramid event that West Liberty has a start value of 10 for all of them. It looks like Fairmont State has a 9.9 for their first heat for their pyramid, but the other two, they will have a 10. So pretty comparable in difficulty for the start.
We'll see how big of an advantage you might see grow here for this Fairmont State side, if any.
And I think a few minutes ago you just said it looks like we have a really good crowd, and we do. It's pretty filled, pretty full.
Full of Fairmont State fans, parents all across the board, various folks here filling up Joe Renton Arena.
Seems like it got quiet.
But he's waiting in anticipation. Yes. You know, they don't want to say too much here as they wait for the video table across from us here to update with the score.
If you haven't had an opportunity to watch a meet in person, I really strongly advise you to see it, because it looks good.
It's
on
a lot of fun.
Video, but it's you miss out a lot unless you're actually here. You miss out on the overall the crowd involvement, the excitement.
There's just a certain energy that you get in a building when an event like this happens, especially when you get towards the end and everyone's excited for that team event. You can just feel the crowd building off the energy of both of the teams.
It really does. It really does. And there's much more suspense, I think, when you watch it in person as well.
Judges just about wrapped up here as we wait to move forward and get some scores. We'll hand over to public address when we have them so you can find out what exactly is going on. But almost to the halfway point here as well, moving along so far, what do you really think has stood out to this point in time on either side, really, if you could point to one thing?
I think both teams, both schools have had a really strong showing. I think, unfortunately, we did see West Liberty have that little fall, bobble that came down. I really like to call it a fall. She just came down. You hate to see that happen, because that can happen to any team at any time.
Right.
And but I think overall both teams look very strong, and they're doing a very nice job. I think that if they stay on track and stay focused, it's going to continue to be a good meet, and we should see it flush out in probably the tumbling and then the team routine.
Don't forget, we will have the individual event finals as well tomorrow here before we get to that championship meet. There's plenty of great things to pick through there. As you take a look in terms of teams that have qualified in what order, Frostburg State, 14 qualifying meets. Fairmont State with 13, Glenville State with 11, West Liberty with 5, and then Notre Dame College checking in with 2 towards the bottom.
Yes, and we're really excited for Notre Dame College to be in it, because they, with the school closing this year, this will be their
final. It's a big name for them, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And their coach was Coach of the Year this year for the conference.
Tough to see a very unfortunate situation. Listen into some scores here, and we'll wrap them up a bit later.
West Liberty, 9.05. Fairmont State, 9.4. 3-5. In the 7-0 heat, West Liberty 7.725. Fairmont State 9.6. Macro event total, West Liberty 25.775. Fairmont State 28.525. There's our beat total. West Liberty at 62.375. Fairmont State at 66.525.
So at this point, looks like Fairmont State has taken about a 4-point lead.
It's now time for the Pyramid Heat 1, the Immersion Pyramid.
We'll see if that continues to grow as we move forward. It's the Pyramid event now, the Inversion Heat coming up, and here are the Hilltoppers to kick us off. To the untrained eye, for some people who might be watching here, is that initial dismount on the way down there, kind of just letting the momentum carry it down there. Would you say that that's more of something that can be practiced, or if it's just one of those things that you tend to lean into and just roll with?
Well, that's a good question. I think that many times, of course, remember, you have to have a 3-second hold in that inverted position, and I'm not sure if they really made that 3 seconds. So I think with that being said, that momentum is what carried it down, where, you know, once you hold it, then you have more control coming down into that dismount.
So you kind of feel the tension, at least from the crowd, when you watch those kind of things as athletes are on their way down, everyone holding their breath, hoping nothing bad happens in that regard. So it's always interesting to pay attention to that sort of thing.
Well, many of the spectators, you know, are fans that follow the respective teams, and they watch the routines, and they know them probably just as well as, you know,
anybody.
Yeah. And you know, with that being said, you hear they know what they've seen in the past, so sometimes they react and respond to that.
We will see Fairmont State coming up here shortly. You can see them on your screen right now, enjoying their home arena advantage, if you will. It's always easier when you don't have to pack up and hit the road for this sort of thing.
It is. Get to sleep in your own bed.
That's the best part. Here are the Fighting Falcons. It was impressive to sit back and watch this Fairmont State side really go to work out there, as they just look to be a solid program all around.
They do a very nice job. They put a lot of hours of practice in, and they work very hard at their craft.
Looks like we've got some totals here on your screen that you can take a look at. Momentarily, at least, as you continue to see the Fairmont State side, as they look to stay loose here. Don't want to look too far forward, if you will, and start necessarily thinking about tomorrow. You want to make sure that you don't, you know, lose focus mentally here and you finish up business.
Absolutely. Well, in talking about I think we may have...
I think the Hilltoppers are actually ready to go. Hold that thought. We'll come back to it here shortly. So impressed by the strength at the bottom of those structures, time in and time out again. That is not an easy spot to be in by any means.
It absolutely is not. Placing your body in that position to begin with and then to hold two more bodies on top of you. It's a talent within itself.
Looks like now we can take a look at the event two scores as they made their way through. Anything really standing out to you in particular to this point in time?
The major part I see is, you know, we see the lower score from West Liberty, and of course that's where that error came into play. Other than that, everything looks pretty consistent going through. Just excited to see how we move forward.
Fairmont State returning again to the mat.
Again, these are two structures, so the synchronization is a key point.
We'll see how that holds up here. Synchronized to me, if you ask me.
Very good synchronization. Now, going back on my other thought, we were talking about tomorrow, and with event finals being in the morning, those individual events are wonderful to come watch. Again, these are all the six different teams within the conference that have qualified for it. So, you know, you're going to see everyone in an event, with the exception of compulsory and team routine, kind of taking place. So they should be really entertaining.
I like to compare it to something, if you will, of it's very common in terms of, let's say, for the NBA or the National Hockey League to have a skills competition during their All-Star weekend, if you will. It's very similar to that.
It does remind you of that, you know, from that perspective.
It's now time for Pyramid 3, the Open Pyramid. Up first, with a start value of 10.0, West Liberty.
Here come the Hilltoppers. Rebound effort looks to continue here, and that seems to be a good way to do so.
Absolutely, absolutely.
One more thing to go here from Fairmont State. We have found ourselves to the break already.
Yes, it's moving quickly.
It really is. Close goes out from Fairmont State. We'll get a chance to hear from both head coaches during the halftime break, as well as look at some of the scores and various other things, and perhaps maybe look forward to some of those event finals coming up tomorrow. Plenty of stuff. Comes Fairmont State now. Wrap things up here, but any final thoughts on at least that from Fairmont State?
Very good showing. That's a good pyramid to end the first half with for Fairmont State.
Any other thoughts here as we get towards the halfway point? Anything that really sticks out to you to this point in time that has really been rattling around up in your brain, if you will?
I just have to say that I'm really proud to see both teams come through. Both the head coaches for both of these teams were actually my former athletes when I was coaching. So,
okay.
I have a strong connection to both of these girls, and I'm so proud of them and watching them as they move forward in their coaching careers. And, I have multiple other contacts throughout that are also coaching, and it's just fun to see them as they bloom and blossom.
We'll quickly step aside. When we come back, we'll break into some things on the half here on MEC TV.
That sounds great.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
Welcome back here, folks, at the half. Fairmont State and West Liberty, and we've reached a good one and halfway through it so far here. Danielle Kutry joining us here. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
So why don't you tell me about the first half here so far? Of course, things are back here in your home arena. That has to be fantastic. Why don't we actually start there? How does it feel to have things back here?
It honestly feels great. I know my girls, my athletes, are very excited to be here. They're more comfortable in their home environment, so
right.
It's great to have it here and just be home with our home crowd.
What should we look forward to in the second half from your squad? What's something you really like to highlight and feature, if you will?
For the second half?
Yes.
Second half, our tosses, obviously. We throw some back double tosses, but I'm also really excited for our tumbling event.
Sure.
We've been pretty strong this year in it, and we've just really worked on it this season, especially the last couple of weeks, really working on perfecting our tumbling, because we've been losing a little bit more than we like in tumbling, so I'm excited to see how they show up today.
And I always like to ask this to everybody here. What's one of your favorite things about this weekend that stands out to you personally that you enjoy the most?
Just all the teams being here. So all the Mountain East Conference athletes being here, being together, cheering each other on, and then event finals. Is always just so much fun because we're all standing around the mat competing for an event title, and it's a fun atmosphere, and just getting to see all the athletes cheer each other on is great.
Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you so much.
We'll step aside here. When we come back, we'll do some more halftime breakdowns here on MEC TV. Thank you.
What are you working for? Do you want to pursue your athletic potential while earning a degree that will benefit you for a lifetime? Do you want to play at the highest level in your sport? Do you want to be a champion? That's what the proud members of the Mountain East Conference are advancing toward every day. Providing opportunities and pursuing excellence. The Mountain East Conference.
The legacy began in 1973. That was the year NCAA Division II was born. And since the very first day, our division has shaped generations of student athletes with a true sense of academics, athletics, and community. That is five decades of graduations, championships, teamwork, and personal development. 50 years of shaping student athletes into world-class leaders. NCAA Division II. Our division, our legacy.
Keith Powell, and I'm in love with helping you get your next car, truck, or SUV. I love saying yes to $2 down. I love saying yes to $200 monthly payments. I love saying yes to up to $2,000 more for your trade. And I love saying yes to your approved with my Keith Says Yes credit approval process. All of this plus a lifetime warranty only at Yes Chevrolet in Hurricane.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
We're there to serve, make sure we're creating a fair atmosphere for both teams, upholding the integrity of the game.
I chose to be an official. It's the best decision I've made.
In life, things aren't scripted. Games aren't pre-scripted. You know, I got into officiating because my father was an official. Officiating was part of our family life. It wasn't just the game.
Get to be outside, get to like experience the game. It's so much more fun. You can get a lot out of it.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
It helped me become not only a better official, but a better person.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
And it's just been wonderful.
Here at the half as we await the event three scores. As we stand this point in time, the lead for Fairmont State 66-525 to 62-375. We'll get ready to go for event four. In the meantime, we can take a look at the event score recaps from event one and two that we do have at this point in time, starting with event one. We'll check on that a little bit later, but in the meantime, we said 66-525 to 62-375. Don't forget, tomorrow we will have event finals coming up before the actual championship meet for the Mountain East Conference. Should be a great time had by all, as always, as we can do a little bit of an in-depth look at how that's going to function tomorrow afternoon. In terms of qualifying heats by institution, it reads as follows. 14 for the Frostburg State Bobcats, 13 for the Fairmont State Fighting Falcons, the Glenville State Pioneers checking in with 11, the West Liberty Hilltoppers will have 5, and the Notre Dame College Falcons will have 2 in their final season of operation. And of course, we'll have the 5, 6, and 7 element acro heats, as well as the inversion, synchronized, and open pyramids. All three tosses of 450 salto, synchronized, and open, as well as the always so fun tumbling section of duo, trio, quad, aerial, 6, and open. We'll step aside when we come back. We'll tear into some more scores here on NBC TV.
At Glenville State University, you can discover friends to last a lifetime, professors who broaden your perspective, and the skills and education for future success in a small town environment. At Glenville State University, you can become a pioneer.
There you can see the event 3 scores on your screen, and where we sit after that, a 9-3-5, a 9-7-0, and a 9-7-7-5 for the number 1 seed Fairmont State. Over on the other side for the 4 seed Hilltoppers, a 9-3-5, a 9-5-7-5, and a 9-7-0 for the 4 seed, and again, West Liberty Hilltoppers, 28-8-2-5 to a 28-6-2-5. Keeping it rather close in event 3. It was really tough to point out any flaws between the two, as it was very, very competitive in that third event as we get ready to start off with the toss event coming up shortly. We'll step aside after we take a look at these meet totals here, 92-6-0 to 91 on the dot. Starting to get a little bit closer here as we head into the back half. When we step aside and come back, we'll be able to hear from a member of the Hilltoppers here. Stick with us here on NBC TV.
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiate.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
Launch your healthcare career at West Liberty University. We offer health science degrees in programs like nursing, dental hygiene, speech pathology and audiology, medical lab science, pre-medicine, psychology, biomedical science, or the physician assistant program. Our faculty have the experience to prepare you for a rewarding future. There's never been a better time to prepare for a healthcare career, and there's no better place than West Liberty University. Find out more at westliberty.edu/healthcareers.
Welcome back here, folks. It's Fairmont State and West Liberty in the 1-versus-4 matchup. I'm joined by Kelsey Kyle, head coach of the West Liberty Hilltoppers here. And Kelsey, to this point in time, it's been a pretty close contest between you two. What can you attribute that to?
Yeah, I mean, I think every time we play Fairmont, every year it seems like we have really close meets. Both teams are super competitive. I think you could see with the compulsory scores how close they were. For us with the acro, had a little slip up. But whenever you're doing hard skills, every team runs that risk.
Right.
So a little bit of a division with the scores with that. But, I mean, I think it's going to be neck and neck until the end.
And for your squad, what should we look forward to here in the second half that you want to feature with your athletes?
Yeah, I would say definitely Kayla Gandy's aerial pass. She has a 10.0 pass. She's been really working hard on it. And then, of course, team event is the fun part.
So much fun.
Yeah.
I agree, without a doubt.
When everything's going on, so there's just so many different skills happening. I think that's always the most fun to watch.
And then I like to ask everybody here before you head off, what's one thing about this weekend that personally excites you that really is the most fun, if I could ask?
I mean, I could talk for an hour about this. I mean, it's just so special for so many reasons. One, I'm a Fairmont State alum,
sure.
So always being back here is really special to me.
Oh, of course.
I think I'm right now the only head coach in the MEC that's still here from the 2019 championship team at Fairmont. So I just have a lot of memories coming back here competing.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine.
Yeah, competing in the first ever MEC tournament with my team and then being back at my, you know, alma mater, watching my team that I coach now. It's just so special. Like I said, I could talk forever about it.
But thank you for joining me. I appreciate you taking this time.
Thank you.
So we'll step aside. When we come back, we'll get ready for the second half of this one. Stay tuned here on MEC TV.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
I'm Keith Powell, and I'm in love with helping you get your next car, truck, or SUV. I love saying yes to only $2 down. I love saying yes to $200 monthly payments. I love saying yes to up to $2,000 more for your trade. And I love saying yes to your approved with my Keith Says Yes credit approval process. All of this plus a lifetime warranty only at Yes Ford in Huntington.
Welcome back here, folks, as we get ready for the second half of this one. Fairmont State and West Liberty. Colin Kirkwood and Christy Kiefer here as we get ready to move into the second half here. What should we be looking for from both of these sides? It's rather close to this point in time.
It really is. I think that as we see the second half, you know, it's going to move a little faster with the toss part, that the toss events, and then we'll go into our tumbling, and, you know, the start values will play a role. Whether or not the athletes can execute at their start value, then, you know, we may see just a little bit more separation in scores.
This is the Hilltoppers taking the mat here. We'll see what they bring. You can see the running score total top right of your screen. West Liberty to kick off the second half. Anything standing out to you in particular?
Good solid beginning coming through. They have a start value of a 9.0 with their toss. If they can execute, keep everything very clean, you know, with their start values, that little drop that they may have that possibly Fairmont doesn't have in start values may pay off for them. Again, that's what the officials are looking for. They're looking for high catches, body position in the air, when they open up, rotation, every aspect you can think of.
Christy, the best in the business, if you ask me, in the way you break these things down. So it's always a pleasure to have you here for this.
Now, would you like for us to put you up on one of those tosses? We could do that after the meet.
We'll have to put that on the back burner. But we'll get ready for Fairmont State's edition here coming up shortly, as you can see them again on your screen. Staying loose, having fun over there on the other side.
Looks like that Fairmont State has a 9.4 start value for their toss, which indicates that they will be throwing a full toss.
Next to a start value of 9.4, Fairmont State.
Here they are. Fairmont State to open up their second half.
Yes, good height on that toss. Good tight body position. As we see West Liberty coming up for their second toss, which is a sink toss, so we'll see two of them together. They have a start value of a 9.4, which indicates that they will also be doing a single full toss.
Synchronized heat coming up here from the Hilltoppers. You have to wonder, maybe if we'll take a little bit of inspiration here from Wiz Khalifa's black and yellow. I can see a couple of them pointing to the jersey colors here. guess you could call it more of a Pittsburgh theme song, but you know, West Liberty can adopt it too.
There you go. Well, you like that Pittsburgh area, don't you?
Big fan, I have to say the least.
So you like
fan.
That black and gold?
Oh, without a doubt. Probably two of the biggest amount of colors I own in my wardrobe. Let's see what this black and gold can come up with here as they get ready to make their way onto the mat. About ready. You can see them waiting here, and now it looks like we are off and running.
The two incident is the synchronized toss. Up first with a start value of 9.4, West Liberty.
Again, we will see two identical tosses, so they're looking at synchronization, timing, lifting, hitting the height at the same time, peaking at the same time, rotating at the same time, and a high catch together. They look good. They look good.
Things did look rather good there. Mm-hmm. I agree. As they make their way off, and we'll see Fairmont State step on here shortly. We move right along here to event four.
I think when we look at tosses, that for the coaches and for the athletes too, that especially for the same tosses, that they have to just look at them over and over again and see who has to make a minor change to make them look identical to match, you know, when it goes for rotation and body position and even catches. Are they having a high catch or is the catch a little lower? Is there a little pike in the catch? So many factors that go into play.
We'll see this group from the Fighting Falcons coming up here shortly. Here they come. Quite the reaction from over there. Do you concur?
Yes, I do. They very, very nice height. Again, you know, they have two twists compared to last one twist, which they're actually getting a 0.5 higher start value because of that different level of difficulty. And with a little more difficult to execute as well coming through. So we've got one more heat in our toss. There'll be their open heat coming up in a minute. You know, one thing about it, seems like we're getting everyone involved, engaged in acrobatics and tumbling. This is really the newest, the biggest phenomenon. I know on our campus here at Fairmont State that you know, I'm a full professor, and I have a colleague that he actually is building like pedestals, and he sells them to teams all across the country, and he ships them to them. And you know, it's you know, getting every, he started doing them probably 8 years ago, so getting everyone involved and take it apart. And I bet you he's listening right now, so if he is, a shout out to Paul Renaud.
Glad to have him if he is here enjoying, as here come the Hilltoppers again. But that catch looked a little bit lower than it should have been.
Yeah, a little more pike in the catch. That's probably going to catch them a little bit, you know, from the officials when they come up with their final score. They had good height on that toss. Actually, I thought the body position in the air looked good, but again, until it just kind of swept through at the end.
We'll have Fairmont State to close out event four coming up here shortly. We'll move into event number five, where things will get a little bit more serious than they already are. I like to think of that as one of the most pressure-filled aspects, if you will.
Absolutely. And again, I said this earlier, and I just want to repeat it, that, you know, we're sitting here just analyzing what we see. We are in no way trying to officiate or be the official scorers of this because, you know, neither one of us are trained. Even I think you do a very nice job with it.
Well, but, I appreciate it.
In, yeah, calling those final scores.
I'll look to close things out here with the Fighting Falcons.
Again, we saw another double full toss, which gives us a little higher start value of 9.9.
We will get set for event number 5, and we'll have event 4 scores coming up after this break right here on MEC TV.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division 2, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
What's possible when you have the freedom to explore things that inspire you? To be a part of a community that supports and challenges you. Where can you go to find the space and time to reach your goals? Who can you become when you're able to make connections in a place where you belong? Find out what's possible at Frostburg State University.
Welcome back here, folks. Heading into event number 5. We'll get scores from event 4 when we get to that point, but already almost at event 5.
Yes, this is the tumbling event. This is one of my favorite events. I love the tumbling. However, with that being said, we will see fewer individuals from each team up, and there'll be more pressure for them at that point. I believe here come our scores.
Sort of see that lead starting to grow a bit more here. That's 123 to 116, 825 now through 4.
Yes, and I think when you look at those scores, you will see that the start values really must be better than what you think, because they gained some ground, but it's just that Fairmont State has such a higher start value.
Right. And for the Hilltoppers here, they're off and running. Here's their duo. Through it here, might have been a bit ahead perhaps, or behind, depending on how you want to look at it on either side.
Yeah, that's you know, as the officials are looking at these athletes as they approach their tumbling passes, they don't actually start scoring them until after, I believe, after the hurdle, when they go into their round off for the first skill. And you know, they're looking at, you know, amplitude, they're looking at body position.
Right.
And of course, with the two, it's just the synchronization as well.
We will have coming up here for Fairmont State, Katie Cole and Riley Vincent will be the duo set to step up.
And these two have a higher start value, however, which means they have a higher difficulty, which puts them at more risk. And as we saw that earlier in the first meet, that didn't pay off, I believe, on one of the meets, in one of the events for the previous meet.
The word flawless, but that was very, very close to that, if you ask me.
Yes, that was a very nice performance. Good synchronization was good height, good. It'll be interesting to see what their final score is. Their start value was a 9.75, so we'll see how close they score to that 9.75 when the scores come out at the end of this event.
Trio coming up for the Hilltoppers, that will be Jillian Hartz, number 8, Avery Ray, number 10, and Kayla Gandy, number 0.
Again, you'll see some of the athletes run from different positions on this side and pick up speed, but they aren't scored at that part until they start the skill.
Struggled a bit there towards the end, perhaps.
Yeah, I think they just have to watch, make sure you stay really squared up when you land coming through. But hey, they stuck it. They stayed on their feet. Again, that's a blind landing.
That's half the battle itself.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Let's have a look here at some scores now. See here the event four scores in the meantime. Anything really jumping out to you?
Yeah, I just noticed that, like, you know, when you look at start values, you know, in heat one, West Liberty had a start value of a 9.0, and Fairmont State had a start value of a 9.4. And so when you look, you can see where really West Liberty is creeping up closer, but it's the start value that makes the difference. You know, same goes with the next one, 9.4 for both of heat two and heat three for West Liberty, and a 9.9 for Fairmont State. But there's less than a half a point difference in that part. So
might as well take a look at meet totals as well to this point in time. You can see how these things break down. Looks like Fairmont State stepping up here, and we'll get to their group now.
Next to the start value of 8.5 from Fairmont State, number 3, Noel Ellison. Number 8,
Darian Sink there again.
And again, that's a coaching strategy. I think that their coach decided to back off on difficulty and went for cleanliness and synchronization and technique. So, you know, they had a start value only of 8.5. You know, however, you will see they'll probably score pretty close to that.
On into the quad now as we wait for this addition from the Hilltoppers. To move right on along, and the winner of this one takes on Frostburg State in the championship meet tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah, with the quad, they have a start value of 8.5, which indicates that they will be doing a full for their tumbling pass. Again, you have to have four different athletes in each one of these three heats, duo, trio, and quad, which means you're accessing nine different athletes through these first three heats.
Looks like the Hilltoppers are ready. Much better that time around.
Absolutely. Now with the quad pass coming up with Fairmont State, they have a 9.1 star value, which indicates that they will be throwing a 1.5. Again, a little bit more challenging, but a little bit higher star value.
About set up and waiting for the green light, if you will.
It's fun watching the athletes as they get ready. It's like they have their own little things that they do. You can tell some of them
little
are in the
rituals,
zone.
If yes. You will.
Some are in the zone, and some of them are, you know, they're over there getting loose, or they pull up their sleeves, or they have, you know, their own little, like you said, ritual.
Talk about the front end right here in front of us on that. That extra bit of spring, if you will, towards the end. How
okay.
big of a deduction would you think that would be, if anything?
It definitely will be a deduction.
Okay.
I really can't tell you what they will take off of it, but also, you know, coming off the mat will be a deduction for that as well, stepping off the mat. So we'll see. It will affect the score a little bit. And again, just keep in mind, you know, what their start values are. We may end up seeing West Liberty's quad pass hours from Fairmont State's from that perspective, you know, because of the deductions of stepping off the mat and controlled landing.
Should be a pretty exciting addition coming up here for the Hilltoppers as we wait for Kayla Gandy's aerial. As head coach Kelsey Kyle said to look forward to this when I spoke to her at the half. She said this is going to be exciting. Look forward to this. It should be something worth watching here for the junior from Washington, Pennsylvania. Left side of your screen. And a lot of different accolades for Gandy, the transfer from West Virginia Wesleyan.
Yes, Kayla has a start value of a 10.0, which again is the highest you can have. So it's exciting to watch these 10-point passes.
Definitely did not disappoint.
Yep, nicely done, nicely done.
Member of the 2023 MEC first team last year was Gandy.
And we talked about the pressure on these athletes. You know, the individual passes, that's one person that is out there with a 10-point pass, which, you know, all of the other heats throughout the meet are all 10-point heats coming through or have the opportunity to be a 10-point heat. So they do have a lot of pressure on them to perform and to execute.
This will be Chloe Smith for Fairmont State to answer, the junior from Parkersburg here in West Virginia.
Chloe's older sister was on the team before, and she's actually one of the coaches, one of the assistant coaches for Fairmont State, and she actually coaches the tumbling.
You could say it runs in the family.
It does.
Momentum on the way in.
Very
here.
Good.
You could see it right off the jump.
Very good.
See Jillian Hartz now answering in the sixth element coming up for the Hilltoppers.
And Jillian has a really good start value as well. She has a 9.75 start value.
From Duquesne, Pennsylvania.
Athletes in this heat will be doing six different elements across the mat.
Another member of the first team all-conference a year ago, as well as on the NCATA academic honor roll. So excelling both in the classroom and here on the mat as well. Continue the control there towards the end as the momentum was starting to give out, if you will. Definitely not easy to do.
No, it's not. It's you know, as they step out, sometimes it's if their timing is off just a little bit, they have to stall it, and I think that's what you see happen here. So it threw her timing off, okay, which, hey, she continued the pass, she finished it, so that's great, that's wonderful. Sometimes we see some athletes, they're not able to do that, so kudos to her for finishing strong in that pass.
This will be Riley Vinson, number 21, answering for Fairmont State.
Riley also has a 9.75 start value with this pass coming up. It'll be interesting to see if she throws the same skills as Julian did.
And above Williamsburg, Virginia, and a junior for this Fairmont State side. Done there.
This takes us to one more heat in tumbling, and this is our open heat coming up. And it looks like that West Liberty has a 9.1 start value.
It will be Avery Ray, number 10, the junior from Texas, for the Hilltoppers to close this out. Bright spot in the classroom for the Hilltoppers. NCATA honor roll and commissioners honor roll for the Mountain East Conference.
Such a great accomplishment for these athletes to be such strong students in the classroom academically as well as athletically on the field or on the mat or the court. And regardless of what your sport is, you know, time
it really speaks volumes that you have that commitment to that as well as what you were brought in to do, if you will. Being able to split your time like that?
Absolutely. The focus has to be point on.
close things out for the Hilltoppers. Any thoughts there on that?
From watching them, I wonder if this is one of our first times in throwing the pass, because they're, you know, just watching the coaches and everything. Sometimes you see that and you watch the athletes, and it's fun to watch them. You know, it's scary that first time you have to do something, and I'm not sure if this was her first time, but...
be Katie Cole coming up number 5 for Fairmont State.
And Katie is the number 10.0 start value tumbling pass that Fairmont State has. And again, you know, many times it's coaching strategy, you know, where they throw it, where it fits in. So hers is in the open pass.
This is also the MEC Athlete of the Year.
He's a very impressive athlete.
Fairmont State, number 5. Katie Cole.
It's the senior from Hartville, Ohio, coming from the right side of your screen. Excellent way to stick it there at the end.
Absolutely. Sometimes you see those expressions when they pop up. You know what they think.
Very happy with that.
Yes, love watching them.
Closed out event 5. We'll take a break and we'll come back and we'll have some scores. And we'll get ready for the team event here as we look to close out this Friday evening of action right here on MEC TV.
What are you working for? Do you want to pursue your athletic potential while earning a degree that will benefit you for a lifetime? Do you want to play at the highest level in your sport? Do you want to be a champion? That's what the proud members of the Mountain East Conference are advancing toward every day. Providing opportunities and pursuing excellence. The Mountain East Conference.
The legacy began in 1973. That was the year NCAA Division II was born. And since the very first day, our division has shaped generations of student athletes with a true sense of academics, athletics, and community. That is 5 decades of graduations, championships, teamwork, and personal development. 50 years of shaping student athletes into world-class leaders. NCAA Division II. Our division, our legacy.
Welcome back here, folks. Moments away from wrapping things up on both sides as we have reached the team event here. At this point in time, the lead stands for Fairmont State 123-116 as we wait on the event 5 totals to make their way in. It might be tough to tell at this point in time depending on how these scores end up stacking up, but you think the Hilltoppers have it in them to find a way to put together a solid team event here and maybe get their way back into this one.
Well, I think that... you know, they'll do their very best, and again, it's all about execution and seeing how well they can put their team event out on the mat and have very few deductions with it.
We'll have the Hilltoppers momentarily for their team event. Looks like we actually do have the scores tallied up here for event 5. Let's listen in.
Tumbling Total. West Liberty 51.475 and Fairmont State 53.55. Bring us to a tug of war with West Liberty 168.3, Fairmont State 176.55.
Well, there you have it, the way it's broken down. 176.55 to 168.30 is the lead for Fairmont State heading into the final event.
Now for the final event, with a 101.49 start value, please welcome to the floor the West Liberty Hilltoppers.
Here are the Hilltoppers as they'll wrap things up. Sit back and enjoy. As they close things out here in this matchup.
Yes, good performance. They had a good showing. And I only saw one acro, I think, that came down a little bit early on the right side of the net earlier. Tumbling looked good. Again, the final scoring comes up to the officials.
Things got a little bit maybe difficult towards the far side over here. Saw a bit of a hold go a bit awry, and I saw a member of the Hilltoppers almost hit the floor there. Was a bit worried for a couple of seconds, but they did recover from that, if I had to point anything out myself.
Yeah, sometimes it is. You just have to take a minute to get yourself, pull yourself back into the zone, so to speak.
Fairmont State working their way out here as they'll look to finish up their portion.
You spoke earlier of the rituals that they have, and this is one ritual that Fairmont State does. They always start, they take the mat from the back of the mat, which is in front of this scoring table.
waiting for their okay signal to step out.
They kind of circle up and they have someone who will get them motivated, get them psyched, and it looks like Riley is that person and coming to the right number. I'm not sure who it is.
Always one member of each team that kind of gets the task to get everybody fired up, and that seems to be theirs. They can sense they're close to taking care of business here.
But again, it's not over for West Liberty or from Glenville from the previous meet, because they do have event finals tomorrow. And I believe they both have a few different teams, different groups in the meets.
Five chances for the Hilltoppers tomorrow afternoon. Ready here as they spread themselves out and get ready.
See if the officials are ready.
Don't forget the winner of this one taking on Frostburg State in the championship tomorrow afternoon. Following individual finals.
We hope to see you here, but if you can't make it, we will be on the air again, so please tune in.
Both aspects of tomorrow will be on the air. You don't have to miss a minute.
So we have an early morning tomorrow, don't we?
I believe this kicks off at 11 o'clock tomorrow.
Yes. Well, it could be worse, right?
Oh, it could be worse, for sure. 11's not the worst.
Remember, we're just on the air. We're not the ones out on the mat. So these athletes have to turn around and do it again tomorrow for the
that can't be easy
individual events. And then the two top teams, which would be Frostburg and the winner of this meet, have to do what would be essentially a third meet almost. They will be ready to celebrate or pass out tomorrow evening afterwards, I'm sure.
And then for some, they'll have to start getting themselves prepared for 2 weeks from now.
Yes, absolutely. No rest.
With a 104.24 start value, let's welcome the Fairmont State Fighting Falcons.
Fairmont State is ready. quite the performance there to close us out on this day one.
Yes, it was. You could tell when they hit a certain point in the routine, every athlete acts differently because they completed what was their difficult piece, their focal point. And it's just fun to watch them and watch them explode as they get closer and closer to the end of the routine.
We will take a quick break, and when we come back, hopefully we will have some scores in the books and able to see who will match up against the Bobcats tomorrow afternoon here on NEC TV.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
I'm Keith Powell, and I'm in love with helping you get your next car, truck, or SUV. I love saying yes to $2 down. I love saying yes to $200 monthly payments. I love saying yes to up to $2,000 more for your trade. And I love saying yes to your approved with my Keith Says Yes credit approval process. All of this plus a lifetime warranty only at Yes Chevrolet in Hurricane.
Legacy began in 1973. That was the year NCAA Division II was born. And since the very first day, our division has shaped generations of student athletes with a true sense of academics, athletics, and community. That is five decades of graduations, championships, teamwork, and personal development. 50 years of shaping student athletes into world-class leaders. NCAA Division II. Our division, our legacy.
Welcome back here, and you can see the meet totals on your screen. Don't want to speak too highly yet. Don't want to give it away for those who are sitting out here on both sides waiting to hear it themselves. But if you could just speak on what you see here to this point in time, as we now know who will be advancing to tomorrow.
Well, we're still waiting for the team event totals to come up. But as it looks right now, you know, we're neck and neck, you know, just about, what, 8 points difference, so.
Try to keep things little, at least in terms of numbers. I don't like to be out here, you know, saying different numbers and whatnot, because you never know who could pick up and think, oh, it's this, but I heard this. You never know. You don't want to spread too many numbers around at this point
right,
in time, you
right.
know.
Absolutely. And you can't compare one meet to the other, you
right.
know, like the one before this and the other. It's, you know, solely within that meet. Even though you may have the same officials, but it's a different time of the day.
Looks like we are here for the final scores. Tomorrow, 272-290-256-800.
Great performance. And as both teams meet in the head and mat together, and we see the coaches meeting, and again, you know, everybody, the meet's over, and, you know, everybody's happy for each other, and you go out and you do your very best, and let the cards fall where they fall.
So one versus two tomorrow afternoon at 3 p.m. as Fairmont State and Frostburg State will meet again. We talked about this at the beginning of the first meet as it was a very very close matchup the last two times. Last time those two got together,
yes.
I should say.
Yes, it was. Yes,
264
absolutely.
Was the score of both sides. It came down to .415 to .390.
Yes, very close. So it'll be a good meet tomorrow. So, again, if you can't make it here in person, please tune in because you will not be disappointed.
We'll have event finals starting at 11 o'clock tomorrow, so make sure you come back and join us then. And the championship meet will be coming up at 3 p.m. right here on MEC TV. Glad you could join us here this evening. Hopefully you enjoyed the coverage. Come back and join us tomorrow. All right.